Hi guys, Codetutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande. With this video, I am going to start a new concept of Android component, that is broadcast receivers. Before getting into what is a broadcast receiver and how they are used, let us understand why would you need a broadcast receiver. Typically in an Android operating system, you will encounter a lot of different type of events that are occurring. These events could be battery low, Wi-Fi availability, incoming call, incoming SMS, Bluetooth device connected, charger connected or disconnected, even more than that. Probably you will encounter a scenario wherein you want to respond to any of these events that are happening in the system. For example, in case a battery low event happens, you want to stop your application using any backend data polling mechanism because that will unnecessarily drain the battery even more. You basically want a mechanism to listen to these events, and for that you would need a listener. This listener will only listen if it is registered to listen to these particular events. If I try to put it in a technical terms, the listener is nothing but the broadcast receiver. And the way you would register this particular broadcast receiver is either in a manifest file or through a code. And the events that we are talking about here are nothing but intents. So whenever these kind of events happen, basically an intent is triggered. We use the term intent is broadcast. And if a broadcast receiver is registered in the manifest file or through a code to listen to these event broadcasts, and if that broadcast receiver is properly declared in the manifest file or in the code, it will respond to these broadcast intents. I will demonstrate this through a code wherein I will implement a broadcast receiver. I will declare that in a manifest file, and then I will make this particular broadcast receiver to respond to an incoming SMS. So that is the overall idea of what we will be demonstrating in this particular demo. So let me open the application that I have already created. You can see that I have a activity here, and this activity layout is pretty simple. I don't have anything significant to show here. It has got a text view with a text message, broadcast receiver app started. Now what I need to do is I will create a class, and let me call it as my broadcast receiver, and this class will extend the broadcast receiver class. Once you extend broadcast receiver, you have to override one of the methods. The only method that you will come across is on receive. So this method gets executed whenever your broadcast receiver gets triggered, and for simplicity purpose I will toast a message here. So that's it. We are complete with the implementation of broadcast receiver. The next part is I need to register this. So in the manifest file, I need to create another tag for receiver and then my broadcast receiver. I need to make sure that I have proper permissions to receive the SMS. So that is why you can see that I have used the two permissions here, receive SMS and read SMS. Read SMS is not required because I am not going to read the content of the SMS. I just want to be able to respond to a SMS that is received. Then I have to also have a intent filter, that is implicit intent concept that I need to use to trigger this particular component. So intent filter and action name. The action value that I need to give is SMS received, and that's it. I have registered my broadcast receiver to respond to any SMS that is received, and I have proper permission as well. And let me run the code now. To be able to send the SMS, I can open the controller here, extended controller, and through a phone tab here, I can send the SMS. So my broadcast receiver application has started, and let me send the SMS, and you can see that I am getting a toast message, broadcast receiver triggered, broadcast receiver triggered. Another advantage of using the broadcast receiver is you don't have to keep the app running in which the broadcast receiver is declared. What I mean by that is I can just close this particular app and still send it, and my broadcast receiver will still get triggered. But there is a problem associated with this particular mechanism. Regardless of whether I intend to read the SMS or respond to an incoming SMS, my broadcast receiver is always going to get triggered. The solution for this is, instead of declaring it in the manifest file, I have to register it through a source code. This is something that I am going to discuss in the next video. Stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Please like, share and comment down the video with your feedback. Take care.